I recently did a video about why we should not be teaching students subtraction strategies and instead focusing on three key concepts around subtraction that help kids develop the strategies for themselves. And I got a response back from that blog post that asked, so does this mean that we should teach place value before subtraction? And should we teach place value before addition? So I'm Christina Tonnevold, the recovering traditionalist. And today I want to talk about why we should teach place value first before we move into helping kids understand addition and subtraction on our quest to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Now, the first thing I want to talk about is that without place value, kids are really just doing single digit addition and subtraction, right? Let's paint the picture for a moment. You know that child that's just going through the motions of adding the ones column, adding the tens column, adding the hundreds column, and all they're seeing it is the digits in that column. They aren't really understanding what's happening. So those are the kids who get to the end and they look at their answer, whether it's right or whether it's wrong, and they have no clue whether or not that answer is even reasonable, because all they've been doing is just three different single digit addition problems or subtraction problems, whichever one you're working on. So to me, if we don't do place value first, all they're really doing is single digit addition and subtraction. It's just practice with our facts. They really aren't learning and understanding how to add and subtract. The second reason why I think we need to focus on place value first before we move into the operations is because if we don't, we end up having to teach rules, but the rules change every time we have a new set of problems to have to add or subtract. So let me show you an example. When kids start moving into multi-digit, we will often get kids who will line up the problems like this. They'll just line them up because our eyes read from left to right. So they want to start there, but we teach them this rule then about, no, don't do that. You've got to line them up to the right. Everything needs to line up to the right, and then we can go column by column once you have it lined up correctly. But then when they move into problems with decimals, they still try to apply those old rules. They will say, oh, well, before we lined it up to the right, so I'm gonna line it up to the right. And then all of a sudden we're like, whoa, hang on a second. It's because they're trying to apply that rule that they learned in order to add and subtract. But that rule no longer applies here. And so then we have to teach them a new rule that it's not about lining up to the right, it's about lining up the decimals. And really, it's not about the rules. The reason we teach those rules is to give them a trick to help them understand what's really happening. But it's a trick because it doesn't work always. So instead of saying we line them up to the right or we line up our decimals, the key understanding, whether you are adding or subtracting, is you have to add or subtract like values. Doesn't matter what kind of addition or subtraction you are doing, you can, if you put your ones with your ones, your tens with your tens, your hundreds with your hundreds, your tenths with your tenths, your hundredths with your hundredths, you can add and subtract, right? Even as they start working with algebra, it's the same idea. So often kids will try to do the x squareds with the x's. They're not the same value. So if they have this understanding that things have to be the same value, that rule applies for addition and subtraction across the board. Even when you get to fractions, that's why you can't add fourths with halves, because they're not the same value. You have to have fourths with fourths in order to add them. Now, my last reason about why I think we should be putting an emphasis on place value first is because when they get to those problems where it's not as easy, where regrouping is required, it actually makes that type of problem way easier. So what I'm talking about is when we get to subtraction problem like this, and we could do the same thing with addition, but regrouping when it comes to subtraction is like the most difficult thing to get kids to wrap their brains around. So I wanted to go with the most difficult type of problem that kiddos are gonna encounter. So when they get to this type of problem, the standard way that we teach it is to have them cross all of these out, right? And replace it with the, you know, what the regroupings are. But when they see it like this, they're still again seeing 15 minus 7, 13 minus 8, and 1 minus nothing. They have no concept about what they just did. What they see is a 1, a 13, and a 15. Was that even correct? They don't know, right? Especially when you get to subtraction across zeros, that becomes super difficult. But instead, if we take that same problem and we expand it out using their understanding of place value, that problem really means you have 200, you have 40 and 5, 245, and you have to take away 80 and 7 out of that. And there's different ways kids might set this up, so this is not the only way to solve that, but let's take a look at what that might look like if kids are trying to do that traditional algorithm if they have this place value understanding. There we go. So what ends up happening is they see what's actually going on with those numbers. It's not just a 1, a 13, and a 15. It's 15, it's 130, and it's 100. And one of the biggest pieces we want kids to understand when they do this regrouping, that's why we call it regrouping and not borrowing now, you've really just taken that 245 and regrouped it. It is all still there. It's just grouped differently. It now has 100, 135, 130, and 15. That still makes 245. It's just grouped differently. That is way different than what kids get here. Totally different understanding. And so even as they move into adding and subtracting with decimals, this same idea holds true. We want kids to be able to understand the value of those digits. And the only way they're going to do that is if we focus on building their place value first before we start moving into the operations. And again, when they go to regroup, I didn't put it on here, but if you did that with this problem, you should see that you still have 2 and 45 hundredths. It's just going to be regrouped in a different way. So I hope that this has helped you understand a little bit more about why I say we need to build kids' place value understanding instead of trying to teach them these strategies. If we build their place value understanding, the strategies come from it. And then all we have to do is just help them find a way to model that thinking that's happening in their brains. So I hope that this helped you build your math mind. And so you can go out there and build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.